So there's a shortcut for finding the decay rate and the half-life t. As we discovered in the previous problems, k times t was equal to natural log 2. So that allows us to find either the decay rate or the half-life rather quickly. If I want to find the decay rate, I could just take natural log divide by the half-life. If I want to find the half-life, that's equal to natural log 2 divided by the decay rate. Let's take advantage of that formula. Plutonium-239, a common product of a functioning nuclear reactor, can be deadly to people exposed to it. Its decay rate is about 0.0028% per year. What is its half-life? So if we want to know the half-life, T, it's going to be equal to natural log 2 divided by K. So the only catch here is you got to be careful and make sure that you convert the percentage of the decay rate into its decimal form. So we would have 0.000028. It obviously decays at a very, very slow rate. Now I already calculated this to save a little bit of time, and it comes out to 24,755.26 years. So for something that's so deadly to human beings, it's unfortunate that it takes so long for it to decay, so that if we were exposed to it, it would then be safe again. One last example. Following the birth of their daughter, two parents want to make an initial investment of P0 that will grow to $10,000 by the child's 18th birthday. Interest is compounded continuously at 6%. What should the initial investment be? We will use the formula P equals P naught times e to the power of kt. We need to find P0 or P naught, which is called the present value. So we want to have $10,000 into the future. So that's our value of P. We want to know what that initial investment must be in order to obtain that $10,000. We know our K is 6% or 0.06. And our time, since they want the child to have that money on their 18th birthday, that would be 18 years later. Let's take a look at the situation graphically for a moment. Essentially what's happening, if we go back to exponential growth for a moment, 18 years into the future, they want to have $10,000. And at time zero, the question is, what should the initial investment be? So that if it grows exponentially after 18 years, we'll end up with $10,000. Okay, so if we go back over to the problem now and try to solve this for P0, we first need to evaluate e raised to this power. I've already found the value of e raised to the power of 0.06 times 18, and that comes out to 2.9447. So now in order to find P0, we simply need to divide. So our present value is going to be $3,395.93. This is the amount they should invest today to have $10,000 18 years from now. Thank you for tuning in and have a good day.